Hey guys, so it's morning and I'm kind of out of it because I pulled an all-nighter to work on this project that I've gotten myself into. I'm kind of regretting right now the project I've chosen. It's very challenging. It's rewriting or updating the group curriculum for the agency I intern at. And it's challenging because I'm not very experienced in group work. So I think I spent so much time just researching and reading about activities and team building activities and things like that. So I finally got a lot of the drafting done. So I made a lot of progress with this all-nighter, so that's good news, even though there's still so much work to do. But if I keep at this pace, I think I can finish. Hopefully I can finish drafting the entire thing by this Monday. I'm pretty confident that could be done. If that somehow I end up being lazy and procrastinate, at the latest, I could finish this whole thing by Thursday. But I hope it doesn't come to that. I hope I could just finish it, knock it out by Monday, and submit it to my supervisor, which I feel bad because my supervisor wanted me to kind of submit it to her piecemeal, like sections at a time, so she doesn't get just like the whole thing at once and be overwhelmed. Unfortunately, that's probably what's going to happen. I did give her some piecemeal on like the beginning progress of it, but it got so messy, like, and you know, I've been procrastinating on this thing quite a bit, and it's been challenging to me. So she's got like the first few pieces of it, but then come tomorrow and Monday, she's probably gonna get the entire thing all at once, and yeah, I feel kind of bad for that because that shouldn't have happened. I definitely should have been better managing with my time, but then there were issues here too, which I'm not really gonna disclose too much about. But yeah, things happen, life happens, stuff happens, and human brain is a mess of jumbles that just doesn't work the way you want it to sometimes, a lot of times actually. But human beings are incredible in that way. It's just how we are, and we kind of have to. Society expects us to get used to it, so we do get used to it. Anyway, so I pulled an all-nighter, which to me isn't that difficult. I am pretty good at pulling all-nighters. I think that's really because I am very nocturnal. And I think I've been this way for a long, long time. Even when I was a high school student, I was more nocturnal than the whole, you know, the school expects you to be at school at 8:30 in the morning and then, you know, have the whole this regular 8 to 4 shift or 9 to 5 shift. It's like an expected thing, Monday to Friday. Of society, most jobs. And I understand that. I understand the reasoning why jobs are like that. But at the same time, for a person like me who really excels during night hours, it's extra challenging for me. And I really do believe that people have different kind of biological clocks that are unique to them. Some people are just great morning people. I have a friend who's just like that. She wakes up 6 in the morning. And goes to bed at like 8 or 9, and that's like her thing. That's her routine. She's very good with routine. I think morning people excel really well because they have a very routine-oriented life. You know, they do certain things at certain time of the day, every day of the week. I can't, like, I've always struggled with routine. I couldn't do routine. I'm a very nocturnal person. I think I'm the most energetic when it's like 2 in the morning, 3 in the morning. Even 4 in the morning. It's weird. It's really weird to have so much energy at the time when everybody is asleep. And it's challenging now because, you know, I am in the social work profession. I'm trying to think of a social worker job that's just like lets me work at night, the night shift from like midnight to 8 in the morning or something. I struggle to think of one, other than like in hospital settings or residential day treatment settings or something like that. And that's not the field I want to get into, as I've explained in my other video. So the thing is, I have to suck it up. That's my problem. I have to suck it up and do my and force myself to get used to, which I don't think I'll ever really get totally used to, the 9 to 5 hours. And that's my personal challenge. You know, it's just a challenge that I have that maybe some other people share too, but many other people wouldn't share. For many other people, 9 to 5 is just 9 to 5. Like, that's what they're used to. And I understand that. For me, it's tough now. Right now, it's 10 in the morning, and starting at 10, that's when I'm just like so groggy. I wake up every morning extremely groggy. Like, it doesn't matter like how many hours of sleep I have. It's so weird. But I'll wake up at 2 in the morning always, and I'll force myself back to sleep. And then I'll wake up only because I have to wake up at like 6:30 in the morning or 7 in the morning to go to internship or to go to class or whatever. And I just feel so awful. I'm breaking out of sleep for this. I feel so awful. Whereas if I wake up in the middle of the afternoon, like 4 in the afternoon or 5 in the afternoon, I actually do feel more refreshed, which is odd. So my biological clock really is suited for a night shift. And that's why it makes sense that, two of my jobs that I worked the longest as a security guard and working in a homeless shelter, they were night shifts. And I really excelled in those two jobs. And a lot of my coworkers would really struggle and try to find somewhere to sleep for an hour during their lunch break, but I took my lunch break like a lunch break. Sometimes I was really tired because I did double shifts. Ugh, double shifts. I hate double shifts. But, when I didn't do double shifts, lunch hour was my lunch hour. At 3 in the morning, I would eat stuff, chill out, read a book. I take my lunch break, and then I go back to work for the rest of the hours. That's just how I am. My biological clock is really, I'm a night owl. It's really weird to think of myself that way. And I think there are many. I think that's another topic for a different video, like how I feel during night shifts and why it works for me so well. But yeah, right now I'm starting to become a little incoherent. But it's just, I'm so groggy in the morning. It's like that McDonald's commercial, you know? There's that guy. I don't know when this was, but it was quite some time ago, this commercial. But it's about this like scraggy white guy who's really tall. He wakes up and he's just like the groggiest person ever. Some people try to greet him and he's like, uh-oh, no, don't talk to me. I haven't had my coffee. Like, screw you guys, no coffee. Like, people try to talk to him. He can't talk to them because he hasn't had his coffee from McDonald's. He goes to McDonald's, takes a sip, and then he's a totally different person. So that doesn't happen to me. I can't go to McDonald's and just be like, oh, grogginess gone. That magic doesn't exist for me. Or for many people, I'm assuming, because that's just a commercial. But I do understand that grogginess. I just wake up in the morning, just like, oh, fuck the world. Like, just let me go back to sleep. And then, it's like I have this headache. And I go to school where kids are so, I don't know, like, I don't know what it is, but kids are so active in the morning. Even, I expected teenagers to be less so. But I guess these are 13-year-old and 14-year-old kids. They're so active in the morning. They're so loud and energetic. It's just like, how do you guys do this? Like, how do you guys have so much energy? Like, I wasn't like that when I was in high school, but maybe that's just me. Although, I did have to wake up early in the morning for zero period. Zero period is a crazy idea, but I had to because I had the passion to play my violin, and my high school didn't have an orchestra because it was a newly built high school. So I had to go to a different high school, which started earlier, so I had to go to their zero period, which was like 7:30 in the morning or something like that. So I had to wake up really early just to play the violin with another group of students. Those were fun times. I remember a lot about my high school. I think I remember most vividly about my high school than any of my other school experiences, which is odd because they say college is supposed to be like the best time of your life, the most vivid time of your life. College is kind of a blur to me, except my freshman year, like my sophomore year, junior year, senior year, just kind of a jumble of blur. But when I think about high school, man, like I can remember so many specific memories about high school, like how I was then, what happened then, like what happened with these teachers, what the classes were. I remember so much about high school. It's ridiculous. I don't really understand why that is. Maybe it's because high school is when I changed the most. High school really is when I changed the most. Like the person that I was before, like I was 16, to person that I was at 17, it's like two completely different person starts emerging, which is why, myself now and myself at 16 years old, so different. Like, I think if I meet a person, if I meet myself, my past version of myself, I'd be arguing with him throughout the day, throughout the night, and who knows how long, how much longer that argument would go. One of us would pass out from exhaustion, probably. Anyway. Like, as you can see, I am rambling on because it's freaking 10:15 in the morning and I'm groggy. But yeah, 10 minutes into this video, I shall cut it quick. I hope you guys have a wonderful Friday. And yeah, cheers.